Have you ever wished you could become invisible? I have.
I've been out here birdwatching for 2 hours, and I haven't seen a single hawk, warbler, or grosbeak. I think they're on to me. But if I could just disappear, I'd be all set. Of course, turning invisible is only possible in sci-fi movies, and in low-budget science videos like this one. But invisibility is not as far-fetched as it might sound. In recent years, physicists have actually built experimental invisibility cloaks. Here's how they work. Light usually travels in straight lines, and if it hits something, it gets absorbed, or it bounces off. That's how we detect visible objects, by collecting the reflected light that reaches our eyes. An invisibility cloak steers light around an object, so that it reflects no light. The key to cloaking is controlling the device's refractive index, or the speed of light in the material. Light changes direction when it passes between two materials that have different refractive indexes. That's why a straw appears bent when it's half submerged in a glass of water. Water has a higher refractive index than air, so the light changes direction when it goes from water to air. The inventors of invisibility cloaks have exploited this property using specially designed structures called metamaterials. A metamaterial's refractive index changes from one place to another, steering the light through in a gentle curve. A cloak made of metamaterials lets light bypass the object, like water flowing around a stone, and the light rays converge again on the other side, so the object casts no shadow. So far, most invisibility cloaks are tiny, way too small to conceal a whole person, and they only work for specific wavelengths of light, so they're not going to help me blend in here. For now, I'll just have to settle for being really quiet.
For Scientific American's Instant Egghead, I'm John Matson.
Thank you.